Hey everybody, my name is JPW03 and welcome back to another game recap. The Lightning win this one 4-3 in overtime. A very exciting game against the Maple Leafs. What else do you expect? Talent was on full display today, and you know, obviously there was a little bit of the celebration for Stammer hitting the 1,000 points at the beginning of the game. If you missed that ceremony, find a way to watch it. Definitely worth it. Super cool to see that. Also, Perry's 1,200th game as well. So a lot to celebrate beginning this game. And Perry had a great game today, I will say as well. So there's a lot of things to review today. So let's go ahead and get the party started. Oh, wait. But before that, let me know what you thought about this game down in the comment section below. As always, here we go. So Lightning on the power play. We're going into the second period. Nothing too much happened in the first. And they're going to score shorthanded. The Leafs are, that is. Marner. Now, this is unfortunate. I don't think we're going to see it in this replay, but Sergachev did a drop pass to, I believe, the referee on accident, thinking that it was probably a Lightning player, and it was just total chaos. Obviously, Pointer lost a stick right there, and Marner gets it, releases it quickly. No chance for Vasi, so it's 1-0 shorthanded for the Leafs. But I love the Lightning's response to this. This is like a few shifts afterwards. Vladdy is going to score. And this is a goal that he needed. This poor guy had an epic preseason, was scoring left and right, struggled a bit as of late, bouncing puck. He finds it first and he just snipes it, honestly. I have no idea how he got that much power and accuracy on it, given the weird spot he was in, but he does. He buries that one. So now we're tied up at one. It would have been really easy to hang your head after giving up a shorty, but the Lightning certainly did not. And we'll get one more look at it. Again, it just kind of hits off of the falling players, Cirelli and Matthews there. Nemestikov gets there first and he snipes it home. And late into the second period, it looks like Pointer's about to score. However, this was correct and I actually saw it live time, so I kind of knew this wasn't going to count. Hagel was offsides when Kucherov actually got the puck. We'll see it again in just a second right here. Take a look. So Hagel is going to touch up, gets into the zone, and then Kuch, as the puck exits the zone again, takes it in really quickly. It was really close, but Hagel definitely was offside, so that was the right call. So points goal does not count. And again, another situation where this could have really taken the wind out of the sails for the Lightning, because right after that point no goal, Nylander is going to come the other way and score for the Leafs to take a lead. So kind of two weird situations. He gets it on his backhand there. Two weird goals, though. Again, a shorthanded one, and then the Lightning score. It's called off or offsides, and then the Leafs score right after. So, again, two major momentum-shifting goals. And however, I love the fact that the Lightning were able to respond today to both of those situations, because, again, those could have been very, very deflating for most teams. So, into the third. Lightning have a 4-on-3 power play here, and they actually really weren't doing a whole lot on it. It was not a great power play up to this point, but Kucher's going to get it. Perry sitting right in front of Murray right there, and he's got no eyes on it, and Kuch is like, you know what, I'll just throw this at the net. It's not a particularly hard shot, it's just an accurate one, and it beats Murray because he never had any eyes on it. So we're tied up at two early in the third. And then to really shift it off, Lightning got another power play basically right after, and it's gonna be Colton right here, just able to get it in the tight angle. But Sergachev with the patience, really, I think everybody on the Leafs thought Sergachev was gonna shoot this puck. He doesn't. He's just going to hold it. We're going to see it right here. Colton actually almost scored earlier. Perry gets it to Sergachev coming in, but just the eyes. I mean, I don't know how Sergi... It was tempting to shoot, I'm sure, but he finds the open man in Colton, and Colton buries that one. So now the Lightning have a lead just like that early in the third period. So really turning the game on its head. And now Toronto on the power play. And you know, if you give them too many, they're going to score. They have too much talent. Broken stick by Paul. Hagel tries to save the day, but it ends up going to Marner, who snipes that one home after, again, the Lightning are just basically a 5-on-3 at this point as Paul goes to grab a new stick. But I love the effort here from Hagel, diving to make a play there. It's unfortunate the puck goes right to Marner, who eventually snipes it home. But you love the extra effort there and at least score on essentially a 5-on-3. And then the Leafs take the lead in this weird fashion, or at least they thought they did. It is definitely a kick in. Tavares definitely kicks this puck in. However, there's got to be a penalty here. If this is called a no goal, there's definitely a penalty happening on this play. just a little bit. It's fine. It's not too big of a deal. They do wave off the goal, rightfully so. You'll just take a look at Tavares' foot. Sergachev does a great job, gets it off the line, but take a look at the foot. He'll kick it in. That angle shows it pretty well. I think we might get one more that really shows it. Yeah, this overhead should definitely show it. Again, great save. That was going in, And then just the kick in. He actually was kicking it wide, but it hits off Vassy's skate, puts it in. Doesn't matter that it touches Vassy. The kick still counts. So no goal on the play. We're tied up at three still. And then we go to overtime, because why not? I mean, a Leafs Lightning game, of course it's got to go to overtime. And this is one Murray has to have. I mean, there's not really much else to say. I mean, great for Killer. Killer's been scoring a lot of overtime winners as of late, but I'm a little perplexed how this one ends up going in, because again, there's nobody in front of Murray. You can see it. He's got to know the shot's coming. He just wasn't really in the right position. And again, good for Killer. I mean, taking the shot, you're in overtime. You never know. Anything can happen, and this shows it perfectly. So Killer does a great job, just shoots the puck, and it somehow goes in. All in all, obviously, very entertaining game. Always is against these two teams or when they play. And but yeah, really got nothing else to say. I mean, a great game. Glad the Lightning got the 2 points. And I think I don't actually know who we play next, but I'm sure you guys will let me know down in the comment section below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Again, please make sure to check out the Nick Paul piece. We posted it. It's plastered all over the page. Go check it out. Give it some love. It's a great piece if you haven't seen it already. And again, my name is JP. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new, leave a like, subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next game. Thank you so much. And as always, go Bolts.